ladies, Change for Talent. Let's continue with the show. I'd like to invite our honorable
Karmatma Saran. We will take this opportunity to bring on stage the legendary Karmatma Saran, the reason we're all here tonight. He's been doing this for 41 years. 41 years of bringing together South Asian excellence in performing arts, fashion, beauty, and I personally have had the opportunity of working with him. I was in the Miss India Worldwide in 2013, and he was nothing but warm. So, to the man behind all of this, Mr. Karmatma Saran.
Thank you, Ayushi. Good evening, namaskar. First of all, a round of applause for Ayushi and Radha. Ayushi represented Nigeria in Miss India Worldwide in Malaysia. I think it was the year 2013. And Radha represented Trinidad in Miss India Worldwide in Dubai in 2011. Am I right? And now both have moved to USA. And Ayushi is in Los Angeles. And Anuradha is in New York. I one call to Ayushi and she agreed to come here to help us. Thank you very much. Without taking much time, I would like to invite few of our sponsors. First of all, I would like to invite Mr. Albert Jasani. Mr. Jasani, come here. We all know Albert Jasani, a cultural and community activist, also owner of these beautiful premises. He has been supporting our organization for many, many years. And while Albert is on his way, Arya is our reigning Miss India USA, has a plaque for appreciation plaque for Albert. Thank you very much, Albert, for your help all these years. We value your friendship, your support. Thank you. Good. Would you like to say a few words?
Thank you very much. Karmatma, you are the great, you are the best, and you are the nice guy, like my uncle. I'd like to invite the Mr. Viru, councilman of the Woodbridge, because I invite the mayor, but the mayor sent him over here, so he will take for 1 minute. Message from the Indian councilman of the first councilman in the Woodbridge. Thank you.
Thank you, Albert Bhai. I would like to thank Karmatma Ji, I think, to do it one of the best, I think, competition. This is Woodbridge Township. So I welcome you all on behalf of our mayor and the council. I think we are really privileged and honored to have this competition here. So Karmatma Bhai, thank you, Ji. And all those also participants, we would like to thank you all for being there, even the parents. It's not all those lovely ladies and good-looking girls. They represent our Indian community, but the way I have heard them, they all have the values. They are truly representative of our Indian community to the Main Street America. So I would like to thank you all for being part of this contest. And also, I would like to thank and congratulate Albert Bhaiya that this time, this is the only year we had one of the best, actually, our holiday parade. And Sri Albert Jasani was the Grand Marshal honored by the township. So thank you to be there. Put our hands together for Royal Albert Palace. First Asian Indian to be the Grand Marshal of the holiday parade. So thank you all for being here. Good night. May God bless you. May God bless America. Thank you, folks.
Thank you, Albert. Thank you. Now, next, I would like to invite the person who does not need any introduction, Mr. H.R. Shah, Padma Shri Dr. H.R. Shah, chairman of TV Asia. TV Asia, H.R. Shah has been supporting our pageant since more than 30 years. I owe a lot to him. Our growth, has been because of his support for since, I don't know, 30 years and more. I really appreciate your support. Thank you very much all these years. And here, Tanvi has a plaque for you, appreciation plaque. Tanvi is our reigning Miss Teen India USA and Miss Teen India Worldwide. I would like HR staff to say a few words.
Good evening, everyone. People are enjoying, right? You know, life may kya when you like old people see the beautiful girl, they say, oh my God, something happening. So my feeling is that whatever he's doing, the pageant, I really, really appreciate. When he came first time, I'm supporting him over 30 years, more than that. Anybody did in this tri-state area some unique to help community, I always support them, always support since 45 years. 45 years. I want to see that they achieve something, somebody achieve something, and they put a USA flag to India. 1.4 billion people, somebody selected and somebody can work on them, like a film industry, singing industry, anywhere. That's I want to see that. In the life, his life, I can consider kabhi khushi kabhi gham. There is happiness and sadness. And when the sadness comes, I'm with him. I'm with him all the time. Money talk, bullshit walk. You know what I mean? That is why I was helping. So, main aapka time nahi lunga. Ek shayari laga kar hum chal jayenge. Wo kya hai ki? I really appreciate from his from considering me. Ek jo log female hai unke liye ek shayari hai ke unke liye hazaron phool chahiye ek mala banane ke liye hazaron phool chahiye ek mala banane ke liye hazaron deepak chahiye ek aarti sajane ke liye hazaron boond chahiye samudra banane ke liye hazaron boond hai par ek stri akeli kaafi hai ek stri akeli kaafi hai ghar ko swarg banane ke liye ek stri akeli kaafi hai ghar ko swarg banane ke thank you god bless you angera dharmatma ji and all the beautiful people who work very hard and who came from all over USA and some people have a sadness they lost that but next time they try they can make it thank you very much
Thank you, HR. Thank you for your support for all these years. Next, I would like to invite Shekhar Rahate. Shekhar, please come and join us here. Shekhar is internationally known fashion designer. He is based in Hollywood. He has a store on Beverly Hills. He has been supporting us for last 20 plus years. He has also choreographed our pageant for many, many years. He has also done a fashion show here some time back. I'm very glad that he has come. He is based, of course, in Los Angeles, a very good friend. And I would like to present this plaque to him. Here is Arya presenting a plaque to Shekhar. Stay a few minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Saran, Mrs. Saran, all of you. So my, that was for me. So my American dream started from this pageant. So the first time I came to US to choreograph and direct Miss India Worldwide, it was in San Jose. And the whole journey started. Now I'm in fashion, high fashion. I do films, I do TV series. And the credit goes to this pageant and Mr. Saran. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Shekhar. Thank you very much. Now, I would like to invite our choreographer, Nishi Bahal. Nishi, please come and join us on the stage. Nishi has been working with our organization for over 25 years, you will not believe. And since last 6-7 years, she has also taken the rights for doing Miss Teen India New York. And I'm happy to say that this year she was recognized as a state director of the year only yesterday. Thank you, Nishi, for your help all these years. And here is Arya presenting a plaque. Thank you, and I would like you to say a few words here.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dharmatma Saran and Neelam Saran, for giving me this opportunity for last, what is this, over 25 years now, right? As not only just as a choreographer, and I'm very happy. This year I got 2 awards. I mean, I always get this award anyway, every year. But this year I got an award for Best Director also. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. And after 41 years, and I think I'm looking forward to have many, many more. Congratulations. And thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Nishi. And next one also does not need any introduction. Here is Shilpa Jurani. You have seen the opening dance number. Opening dance number was choreographed by Shilpa. And she had just started her entertainment company, RS International, and I wish her all the best. Here is Tanvi presenting a plaque to Shilpa. She works very hard for our organization, and I really compliment you, Shilpa, for all your help. Thank you. Say a few words.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I want to take this opportunity to thank Dharmatma Uncle, Neelam Aunty, and the entire IFC committee. Thank you for hosting this platform and making this possible and connecting us all to our cultural and heritage roots. And this is the torch that will take our culture and heritage forward. I would like to take this opportunity to also thank us and give all our contestants a huge shout out for their hard work, their unconditional determination, passion, and their families, because it's all of you, because of all of you that you're here, and they are our backbone to make the heart and soul of this pageant. To our state directors, thank you for giving us a home in your state. I think we can all go to any state and say we have a home there. To our contestants, to opening up their hearts to us. And last but not least, thank you all for being here, and our esteemed judges, our celebrity judges, and guest of honors. And I look forward to many, many more years. This is 41, and I shall be on this platform, God willing, until I'm 100 plus years old. So thank you and have a good night.
Thank you, Shilpa. Thank you very much. Last but not the least, I would like to invite Sunil Izzo, Media Logistics. He has been doing audiovisual for us again for over 25 years. Sunil is on his way. The Cannes Audiovisual is organized by his company, Media Logistics. And of course, he has been with us for over 25 years. Thank you very much, Sunil, for your support all these years. I really appreciate. Now, Arya has a appreciation flag for you. Thank you, Sunil. You have been very, very supportive. Just one call to him and everything is done. I don't have to tell him what he has to do. Say a few words, Sunil.
27 years, I have to say thank to Dharmatma ji and Neelam ji and the entire team. This is not only me or Dharmatma ji and all the people that you see on the stage. Behind the stage, there are more than 20 people who work behind this, everything being here, including Abby, who is doing a sound, and their team. There's so many people there that you don't see in front of the stage, but behind the stage. I thank you all for being there. Everyone who's here is part of it. Thank you so much. I appreciate Dharmatma ji.
Thank you, Sunil. Now, let's continue with the pageant. Thank you for your time. Thank you. Here is Anuradha.
Another round of applause for all of our great representatives and Dharmatma Saran. Without Dharmatma Saran, we wouldn't have had this platform. He began 41 years ago, and that's a huge accomplishment. Now it's time for our talent round. Some of these girls have spent precisely their whole lives preparing for this specific round, and some chose a new talent and found a new way to express themselves. So let's begin the teen talent competition with Ojasvi.
ਅੱਖਰਾਂ ਬਦਾਮੀ ਇੱਕ ਲਾਟ ਵਰਗੀ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਸੀ ਮੈਂ ਦੇਖਿਆ ਏ ਹਲਾਕ ਕਰਦੀ ਕਿੰਨਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਦਿਲਾਂ ਤੇ ਚਲਾ ਗਈ ਆਰੀਆਂ ਜਦੋਂ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਮੇਰੇ ਨਾਲ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਦੀ ਕਰਦੀ ਸੀ ਪਤਾ ਹੱਥ ਉੱਤੇ ਟਾਈਮ ਦਾ ਦੂਰ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਦੇਖ ਮੇਰਾ ਦਿਲ ਸਹਿਮਦਾ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਮੇਰੇ ਕੋਲੋਂ ਹੱਥ ਜਾ ਛਡਾ ਕੇ ਹੁਣ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹੋ ਗਏ 9:45 ਹੋਏ ਹੋਏ ਨੀ ਤੂੰ ਸੋਹਣੀ ਬਾਲੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਦਿਲ ਮਿਲਣ ਨੂੰ ਕਾਲੀ ਕਾਤੋਂ ਤੂੰ ਡਰਦੀ ਕੁੜੀਏ ਲਾ ਲਈ ਮੇਰੇ ਨਾਲ ਜੇ ਯਾਰੀ ਹੋਏ ਹੋਏ ਨੀ ਤੂੰ ਸੋਹਣੀ ਬਾਲੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਦਿਲ ਮਿਲਣ ਨੂੰ ਕਾਲੀ ਕਾਤੋਂ ਤੂੰ ਡਰਦੀ ਕੁੜੀਏ ਲਾ ਲਈ ਮੇਰੇ ਨਾਲ ਜੇ ਯਾਰੀ ਖਿੱਚਦੀ ਤੂੰ ਸੈਲਫੀ ਆ ਪਲ ਫੋਨ ਤੇ ਬਣ ਗਏ ਨੇ ਟੈਟੂ ਤੇਰੀ ਗੋਰੀ ਧੋਣ ਤੇ ਧਿਆਨ ਨਾਲ ਵਾਈਨ ਦਾ ਗਲਾਸ ਫੜਦੀ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਲਾਉਣਾ ਨੀ ਮੈਂ ਦਾਗ ਕੋਈ ਲੂਈ ਵਟਾਉਣ ਤੇ ਦੀਦੇ ਉਹਦੀ ਹੋਸ਼ਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪਲਾਉਂਦੀ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਨਖਰੋ ਮੈਂ ਰੂਹ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੀ ਬਾਕੀਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਲਾਵੇ ਲਾਰੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਨਾ ਕੋਈ ਲਾਉਂਦੀ ਦੇਖ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਹੱਸਦੇ ਆ ਜਾਵੇ ਸ਼ਰਮ ਆਉਂਦੀ ਬਾਲਾ ਜਦ ਸੀ ਪਾਇਆ ਰੋਲਾ ਦਿਲ ਕੀ ਉਹਦਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੋਲਾ ਦਿਲ ਕੀ ਉਹਦਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੋਲਾ ਉੱਡ ਗਈ ਉਹਦੇ ਮੁੱਖ ਦੀ ਲਾਲੀ
ਪਾਰ ਗਈ ਮੈਂ ਸਭ ਕੁਛ ਤਜਰਬੇ ਹਾਰ ਗਈ ਮੈਂ ਖੁਦ ਹੀ ਖੁਦ ਕੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਰਹੀ ਮੈਂ ਉਹ ਸਜਣਾ ਪਰ ਤੂੰ ਮੁਝ ਪੇ ਨਜ਼ਰ ਕਰੇ ਨਾ ਥੋੜੀ ਸੀ ਵੀ ਫਿਕਰ ਕਰੇ ਨਾ ਮੰਨਤ ਕਰ ਕਰਕੇ ਥੱਕ ਗਈ ਮੈਂ ਉਹ ਸਜਣਾ
ਲੱਖੋਂ ਕਾ ਦਿਲ ਤੇਰਾ ਯੇ ਤੇਰਾ ਥੰਡਰ ਸਾ ਠੁਮਕਾ ਅਬ ਨਖਰਾ ਨਾ ਕਰ ਤੂੰ ਬਿਜਲੀ ਬਣ ਕੇ ਬੇ ਤੂੰ ਫਲੋਰ ਪੇ ਆ ਗਿਰ
ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਨਾਚ ਨਾਚ ਮੇਰੀ ਰਾਣੀ ਰਾਣੀ
ਨਖਰੋਂ ਬਦਾਮੀ ਇੱਕ ਲਾਟ ਵਰਗੀ
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਓਜਸਵੀ And now I'd like to, thank you. And now may I have someone to clean the stage, please, so we can have our next performer. Thank you.
All right, New Jersey, while we get set up for our next contestant, how are we enjoying the night? Come on, New Jersey, you can do better than that. How are you enjoying the night? So while we're preparing for the next contestant, how about we hear from our celebrity guest here tonight, Mr. Abhimanyu Dasani. Any words for our contestants, and how are you enjoying the evening so far?
Yo, I'm having a great time. Thank you for having me here. It's a pleasure and an honor to be invited here and be amidst so much of grace and beauty all around. It's an amazing platform for the women, and I feel empowered women empower women. So true beauty lies within, and when you truly believe in yourself, then it illuminates the world outside with grace and with kindness. So what we see here today, it's very easy to stand in front of a camera at home on your phone and do it in the room where no one's watching you. But a big round of applause for all the contestants that come out over here and stand on the stage where the lights are glaring at you and about 500 people are staring at you. And they have to be confident, they have to be composed, they have to be poised. And at the same time, they have to impress y'all with their grace. I think it's an extremely tough situation to be in. And best of luck to all the contestants here, and I hope everyone just has a good time, because that's what it's all about, to enjoy yourselves and to pursue this with all happiness hai. Cheers, guys.
Thank you so much. We look forward to seeing you on the big screen once again and wishing all our contestants all the very best for the crowning. So we look forward to seeing you in a bit. And a little message from HR Shah to our audience for our celebrity.
He's a new generation actor. And we are old now, right? Not everybody old. I'm old. So we have to support. No, you are young, okay? Yeah. Then let me tell you one guy say ek interesting baat karta hu. To ek aadmi ka 10 years hua divorce ho gaya. And the one guy went to one place golden ceremony like 50 years together. To maine bola ke bhai tera divorce ho gaya to you join the club sadibarbadi.com. You join the club sadibarbadi.com and golden ko bola tumne join kiya tha sadi.com. So he covered as a golden jubilee. So he is an actor, and we have to support new generation. Let's work together with him, whatever he need, and we consider him good luck. God bless him, and he can make it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you,
thank you so much, Mr. Shah. Thank you so much, Abhimanyu, for gracing your presence this evening. So New Jersey, are you ready for our next contestant? You can do better than that. New Jersey, are you ready for our next team? All right, now I'm going to, without any further ado, hand over the mic to our MC to introduce our next team. Our next contestant, talent, is contestant number 18, Vera.
Everybody.
Thank you, Vera, for that energetic performance. Let's hear it one more time for Vera. Our next contestant is contestant number 13, Saloni. Contestant number 13, Saloni. Next up, we have contestant number 12, Sakshi.
An empty cup cannot fill another's cup, but a full cup very organically flows into many cups. Self-love is my way of filling my cup, accepting myself for who I am. And this dance is my calling to honor myself.
Contestant number 12, Sakshi. Thank you. And our final contestant in the teen talent round is contestant number 4, Druti.
Thank you. Excellent job. Guys, wasn't that amazing? Now, moving on to Mrs. India USA. And coming up on stage, we have Shilpi, contestant number 16. Yeah, I got it. Contestant number 16, Shilpi. We have Shagun, contestant number 15. All the best, Shagun.
Kaun hai wo jisne mudke mujhe nahi dekha? Who is he?
Main hoon Shin Chan. Ooh, Kareena Kapoor auntie.
How dare you call me auntie? I'm Pooh. वैसे सुनो, am I looking fat?
हाँ, पर मेरी मॉम से कम.
Not fair. Fat का मतलब है pretty, hot and tempting. Hallelujah.
अरे, मेरी मॉम कहाँ से आ गई? इनसे मिलिए, ये है मेरी मॉम मिची नोहारा, जो अगले साल अपने 30s को अलविदा कहने वाली हैं, लेकिन सुपरमार्केट जाने के लिए एक घंटे तक मेकअप करती हैं। शिनचैन, तुम अपना मुंह बंद नहीं रख सकते क्या? और तुम्हारी इटालियन टीचर मिस लूसी की फिर से कंप्लेंट आई है, तुमने कुछ किया होगा।
नहीं मॉम, मैं सच कह रहा हूँ, मैंने कुछ नहीं किया। ये मिस लूसी कहाँ से आ गई?
एलोरा, where is your homework? Where is the mood board? I told you to choose the colors according to the mood board, but you will never listen.
Poo, मुझे बचाओ। Miss Lucy मुझे कितना डांट रही है।
Shin-chan, अब इतनी भी acting मत करो। Miss Lucy ने तुम्हें इतना भी scold नहीं किया है। Okay, take a chill pill, come to my home, play with Taimur, but after that you have to do your homework. Okay? Come. Deal?
जल्दी चलो, इससे पहले मॉम मुझे फिर से डांटे।
Laughter is the challenge that helps us overcome life's perspective in a much fresher perspective, and it's in the symphony of life. It helps us overcome life's challenges. Thank you.
Thank you, Shagun. Going up on stage is the beautiful Sneha, contestant number 17. Amazing job, Sneha. Up next, we have Mona Lisa, contestant number 9.
Hey, see.
से मैं नंदियाँ सजना कैसे वैसे ना घबराऊँ सजना कैसे आईना ऐसे मोहे लाज सजना छूना ना देखो मोहे आज सजना
We have Ananya, contestant number 3.
We live in a world conflicted over the choice of religion, language, color, and creed. How did we come to this? How could we let it prevail? Despite all the advancements in so many other walks of life, we forget that we are humans before we are a community. Just as we forget that we needed hope before we learn to rely on what we call our faith. Darkness come around and everybody fights with a brother. And everybody wants control, don't hesitate to kill one another. So come back as Jesus. Come back and save the world. Bless all the future of every boy and girl. Come back as Rama. Forgive us for all we've done. Come back as Allah. Come back as anyone. Krishna.
Wonderful. Now, let's move on to the Miss India USA. Starting, we have Shweta, contestant number 16.
Shweta, you have a meeting right now.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm busy right now.
As a dancer, my heart is at home. Dance brings me to life, makes me feel complete. My passion for it will never deplete.
Couple Grammys on him, couple plaques, ayy. That's a fact, ayy. Throw it back, ayy. Throw it back, ayy.
Up next, we have Ishita, contestant number 8.
Kingdom rejoices, celebrating the birth of the princess. Everyone follows her journey, witnessing her growth. She blossoms into a captivating young woman. Relentless training transforms into a fierce warrior princess. But then societal norms, people's opinions, and constraints set on women shatter her. Amidst despair, goddess Durga appears. Her voice unveils the hidden strength and princess's true potential. Get up! Others' opinions don't define you. You are much more than that. Rise above and embrace your strengths.
Contestant number 8, Ishita. Thank you so much for a lovely performance. And now it's time for our next contestant, number seven, Girishma.
Hello? Hello, hello?
Good evening. As Indians, we are all familiar with the immense beauty of our motherland. From the expansive Goa beaches to the mountains of Himachal Pradesh, the lush Kerala forests to the ever-flowing Godavari River. The natural realm is essential to our being. Unfortunately, pollution and deforestation are putting nature at risk, and it is our duty to protect it. Today, I will sing to call attention to the preservation of our beautiful Mother Nature.
Thank you.
Contestant number seven, Girishma. Thank you. Our next contestant is contestant number three, Avni.
Hello? Perfect. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, judges. I would first of all like to start off with a beautiful quote by Kalpana Chawla. She once said that a strong woman is a woman who is determined to do something that others are determined not to be done. The reason this stood out to me is because I believe that 6 years ago, I was that definition of a strong woman, standing in front of my parents saying, "Mom, Dad, I want to play tackle football, boys tackle football." I knew my journey would never be easy, because every boy constantly brushed me aside, never imagining that I could ever play on the same fields that they were. There were times when I was mistaken for a boy. I was told to give up because apparently football was too rough for girls. I was tackled harder during practices and games. But I believe that regardless of what other people said, I had persevered because I had realized that I had to compete with them, not just through my skills as a player, but rather the power I had held in my mindset, this notion that I didn't want to quit. 4 years later, I was interviewed by Newsday. Let's take a quick look at that interview.
Wide receiver, Plainfield Bethpage, John F. Kennedy High School.
Avani D'Souza has done the same thing. As a seventh grader, she put on the pads for the Plainview Old Bethpage JFK Middle School football team.
In seventh grade, my gym teacher, he was like, "Oh, who wants to sign up for football?" And all the guys got up, and then I was like, "Well, this is my chance," so I got up.
They got up, so I got up. I became a part of the first female flag football team on Long Island, also later featured in the Jets documentary. Most importantly, if I win this title of Miss India USA, I continue my endeavors, especially reaching out to school districts in my country, speaking on the topic of women's empowerment, while continuing to fight for more opportunities for women's sports. I strive to be the woman that this crown should rightfully represent, a woman who is a barrier breaker, a dreamer, and inspirer. Thank you.
Thank you, Abneem. And finally, we have Rachel, contestant number 13. Job, Rachel. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time now to bring up on stage the reigning Miss India USA, Arya Valvekar. She'll be giving her outgoing speech.
August 5th, 2022. This was the day that everything transformed. From the moment that crown was placed on my head, I knew that my life would be changed. Namaskar, everyone. My name is Arya Valvekar, and I am your Miss India USA 2022, as well as your Miss India Worldwide first runner-up. I've always believed in Premaiva Rudhayani Bandhanati. Hearts are bound by love, and love only. When we act, speak, think with love for ourselves, for one another, love becomes not just a word, it becomes a movement. I wanted my year to be a reign rooted in love and acceptance from advocating for transgender communities in India, attending LGBTQ pride celebrations in Pune, to raising over $3,000 for destitute women, children, as well as the mentally handicapped for Mahir Ashram, I'm using my voice with love, for love. To the girl who earns my crown next, know this, Vidyadhanam Sarvadhanat Pradhanam. Knowledge is the greatest form of wealth. This is an opportunity for you to learn and spread knowledge. This crown is not meant for catching dust on a shelf. You better believe that I made full use of the opportunities that came my way, whether it be emceeing shows for celebrities like Sonu Nigam, Atif Aslam, Shreya Ghoshal, and Arijit Singh, or allowing my modeling and acting career to take off not just here in the US, but in India and in Bollywood as well. To Mama, Baba, and my little sister Ahana, all those nights staying up, practicing my walk, talent, Q&A, that really paid off, didn't it? Thank you for your relentless support and your unwavering belief in me and my talents. Dharmatma Uncle, Neelam Aunty, you always took care of me like I was your own family. I thank you for this platform which has changed the trajectory of my life. And to you all, to my Indian community, thank you for your unyielding support. The power of one, when multiplied by many, is a force for transformation, for change. You have been the wind beneath my wings, launching me to new heights and inspiring me in my reign. It is your words of encouragement, your ashirvad, that has allowed me to bloom. I hope to have made you all proud. As I stand here before you all today, my heart is filled with overwhelming, bittersweet emotions, and it is with both joy and a little bit of sadness that I bid you farewell as your reigning Miss India USA, the journey that began with a dream and ended with the honor of wearing this crown has been nothing short of extraordinary. I have made myself proud, and I hope I have made all of you proud as well. I'll end my speech with this. As I close this chapter of my life, I know this is not the end. I'll be opening a new chapter and writing my own beginning. Picture abhi baki hai mere dost. Thank you so much, everyone. Love you all and take care.
To request Judge Monica Gill to please give our reigning queen a token of appreciation. The pageant continues with our teen contestants. We'll be announcing the subtitles. I'd like to invite all of our teen contestants to the stage, please. Contestants up on stage, please.
Could we please have our Bollywood star, Abhimanyu Dasani, up on stage to sash the subcategories? Let's begin. For our first teen, Miss Beautiful Face, Dia. Beautiful face, Dia. All right, the next subcategory is Miss Social Media, and that goes to Sohani. Social Media, Suhani. Our next teen, Miss Talented, Sakshi. Smile, Dhriti. Category, Miss Popular, Alicia. Miss Photogenic, Anika. Miss Monica. All right, now let's hear it for Miss Congeniality, Simran. Simran. Thank you so much, Abhimanyu. All right, can we have our top five up, please? And to the rest of the ladies, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations. My personal favorite round, the question and answer round.
I think it's their most stressful round. Through rehearsal, each one of them, they were coming up to me. Can you give us any suggestions for question answer round? Don't be so stressed out. Remember, do your best and forget the rest. All right, ladies? Yeah.
All right, let's start with Ojaswi. Are we going on? Ojaswi, do you think sports are an important part of school?
Thank you so much for this question. Each and every kid has their own department where they specialize or where they find interest. For some, it's sports. And sports is a category where one can express how they feel, one can express their competition, and it's a great thing to have in life. It's a great skill, and I really admire those who are great at sports. So yes, sports is a great addition. Thank you.
Great job. Our next contestant number 18, Vera. Vera, what is your biggest fear? I'll repeat that. What is your biggest fear?
Thank you for this question. I personally would say my biggest fear is public speaking, but by doing this pageant, it has helped me get over this fear, which is truly a blessing in itself. I volunteer within the foster care system and have been doing so with my service project, Fostering Futures, and I like to show them by doing this and getting over my fear of public speaking that it is okay to be your true self and you can do anything that you put your mind to. So my biggest fear is definitely public speaking, but I would like to persevere past that, and that is exactly what I'm doing. Thank you.
Thank you, Vera. Let's give her a round of applause for overcoming her biggest fear. Our next contestant is contestant number 13, Saloni. Saloni, hi. What is your opinion on social media? Do you think it helps or hurts our society?
Thank you for that question. In my opinion, social media is a great resource. A lot of my friends live in Germany and Spain, and social media is my way to connect with them when I can't see them for long periods of time. And even though social media can be overused and can be negative in some people's lives, I think overall it definitely benefits a lot of people and makes our community stronger. Thank you.
Well said. The next contestant is Sakshi, contestant number 12.
Sakshi, what would your response to be to a person who believes that pageants aren't a good influence for women? I'll repeat that. What would your response to a person who believes that pageants aren't a good influence to women?
I strongly believe in the quote that beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So when somebody thinks that pageants aren't good for women, that is truly their perspective. My response to that would be, look at us now. We are up here more empowered than ever. And we're up here not only to display our physical beauty, but more so, we're here to unleash the empowered, strong women within us. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next contestant, contestant number 4, Dhriti. Okay, Dhriti, what is your favorite food and why?
My favorite food is definitely idli sambar, because who doesn't love it? Every single time I'm going to a restaurant, it's always that. Am I right? All the time, it's always rice idli with sambar, so good. And it's almost everyone's favorite. I always like to put people on. Thank you.
It's my favorite. Let's give these lovely ladies a round of applause for being so eloquent and so poised. Thank you. Thank you, ladies. Our top 5 in the teen contestant round. Thank you. We would now like to invite Mrs. India USA contestants up on stage. Circle bigger again. Okay, we're gonna start with Mrs. Beautiful Face, and that goes to Harpreet. Why don't you take a walk? Mrs. Beautiful Eyes, Kajal.
Mrs.
Bajo. And now, Mrs. Photogenic goes to Raksha. Raksha, please stand there. Photogenic Raksha. And now, Mrs. Beautiful Smile goes to Shagun. Shagun. Mrs. Talented, Manisha. Manisha. Next, Mrs. Catwalk, Harsh. Mrs. Catwalk, Harsha. Mrs. People's Choice goes to Sunita. Mrs. Chairman's Professional goes to Shilpi. Five up, and to the rest of the ladies, thank you so much for joining us. Top five, please step forward. And we are back to our question and answer round. Contestant number one is Shilpi. Shilpi is contestant number 16. And Shilpi, your question is, if you were a parent, What one value would you teach your child and why?
Thank you so much for the question. If I was a parent, the one value that I would teach my child would be kindness. Be kind to every single person, not because of their status or their stature, not because of the money or because you can get something out of them. Just be kind to everyone, because one act of kindness can change the world. Thank you.
Well said.
Our next contestant is contestant number 15, Shagun. Shagun, what constitutes true beauty? I'll repeat that. What constitutes true beauty?
Thank you for this beautiful question. I think beauty is something which cannot be seen. It is something which must be felt with the heart. And I think compassion resonates beauty. If one is compassionate, one is beautiful. I believe that if any time we feel that we are able to give our best is when we are kind to others. If we are true to ourselves is when we are kind. And I think beauty defines that. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next contestant is contestant number 17, Sneha.
Sneha, your question is, what do you feel is the biggest problem between parents and children today?
Thank you so much for that question. I believe that the biggest difference between parents and children today are a difference in values. Parents sometimes, not purposely, but have a more retired sense of value, but that is not due to because they do not know enough about a particular subject. I believe that children and parents, when they can align their different values, can contribute to a better and more happier family together. Thank you.
Well said.
Next up, we have contestant number 9, Mona Lisa. This was actually my question at Miss India Worldwide. Are you ready? Who do you consider to be the most influential woman of today and why? I'll repeat that. Who do you consider to be the most influential woman of today and why?
Thank you for the question. According to me, I feel women have broken all the stereotypical shackles of the society to rise everywhere. And to me, all women hold place in my heart. But to choose one woman, it would be Mother Teresa, because I believe in her empathy in touching the life of others, because I feel touching one life, contributing to one life changes the whole world. That's the best we can give in today's busy world. Thank you.
Thank you, Mona Lisa. And last but not least, our final contestant is contestant number 3, Ananya.
Ananya, if you had a choice of living anywhere in the world, where would it be and why?
Thank you for this question. The other place in the world where I would choose to live, or another country, would naturally be India. There are so many similarities about between India and USA in that both countries being a melting pot of sorts, where we come across an amalgamation of maybe race here and cultures back in India. I see so many similarities, and being so fresh off the boat, as you'd call it, I would definitely choose India, the place to live, if not here. Thank you so much.
It's lovely. And that wraps our question and answer round. Thank you so much, ladies.
Let's hear it for our top 5 contestants in the Misses category.
We would like to bring on stage Miss India USA contestants. Ladies, come on up. Also like to invite Mr. Ganga Mukhavali to come up on stage to sash the winners of this round.
Sorry about that. We'll begin our subcategories now. Our Miss Beautiful Hair, Shruti. Shruti. Miss Beautiful Smile, Siri. Miss Beautiful Smile, Siri. Miss Catwalk, Natasha. Miss Catwalk, Natasha.
And Miss Photogenic goes to Ashwini.
Miss Photogenic Ashwini. Up we have Miss Congeniality, Ishita. Miss Congeniality, Ishita. Now we have Miss Beautiful Skin, Grishma. Beautiful Skin, Garishma.
And now we have Miss Beautiful Face, and that goes to Avni.
Miss Beautiful Face, Avni.
And now, Miss Beautiful Eyes is Geetika. Up next, we have
Miss Social Media, Neha S. Thank you, Neha S. Up next, we have Miss Talented, and that goes to Shweta. Miss Talented, Shweta. Our next category is Miss Bollywood Diva. Miss Bollywood Diva, Napika. Miss Bollywood Diva, Napika. Miss Popularity, Dhruvi. Miss Popularity, Dhruvi. And now, Miss Chairman's Professional goes to Purnima.
Miss Chairman's Professional, Purnima.
Congratulations to all of our winners. Thank you so much for joining us up on stage. Can we please have the top five step forward? Can we also have Mr. Ganga Mukkavili to come up on stage to do the question and answer round?
Thank you. An applause for the ladies who just left the stage, folks. Come on. Are yaar, if you don't support them, who will? Taliyan bajaiye na. Ha, ye hui na baat. I think you will feel better as soon as they applaud more, right? You agree? You'll feel better when they applaud more.
Yes.
See? Come on. You gotta encourage these lovely ladies, okay? I have five questions here, judges. I'm gonna repeat the question twice so they have time to formulate. It's random, I'm gonna give them a choice. I have no idea which order they're in. So is there any order I should go in? Maybe I'll go from that side. Fair enough? My name? Their name. Okay, I know you don't want my name. Okay, contestant, say your name.
I'm Avni. Good evening, everyone.
Okay, you have a choice of five questions here. Select any one of these cards. And here's your question. In fact, you know what I'll do? Why don't you step forward? There you go. So now you know who's the contestant. In your opinion, and I'll read it twice, in your opinion, which is the most interesting tourist attraction city in the United States and why? Once again, in your opinion, which is the most interesting tourist attraction city in the US and why?
Since I'm from New York, and I've been to New York City many times, I say New York City. But I say it because of the diversity in the culture, in the music, in the food. When I go to New York City, I don't see one culture or anything. I see a variety of different people. I speak to different people. I learn new ideas. And that's something I've learned, obviously, living in New York City, but that's something I take with me if I win this title. is having that ability to connect with a diverse range of people. And I think that is a very important skill to have. And living in New York and especially visiting that area, I've picked up on that skill, and that's what I would bring with me. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Going down the list, the blue one. All right. And you may want to step up. That's it. Oh, sorry.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ishita, contestant number 8.
Nishita, I'm going to repeat the question twice. Traditionally, men have courted women. If you were to see an interesting eligible bachelor in the audience, would you break the tradition and make the first move? Again, traditionally, men have courted women. If you were to see an interesting eligible bachelor in the audience, would you break the tradition and make the move first?
Thank you so much for the question. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I feel we've been thinking a lot about these traditional norms, conventions. But come on, it's 2023 and we gotta break out of it. So if I would find someone wonderful, handsome, that's not the priority, but kindness, patience, and him being content with himself, then I would go with him. And of course, I would break any bounds if I find the right one who's my dream partner. Thank you.
Thank you indeed. It's okay. You gotta understand, it's very difficult to be on stage and do this. So the more you applaud and encourage these lovely young ladies, the better it is for everybody. Here you go. And you're gonna say your name.
Hello, everyone. My name is Grishma.
Okay, your choice.
I'll take this one.
Okay. And I'm going to repeat twice again. What aspect of Indian culture you admire most and why? What aspect of Indian culture you admire most and why?
Thank you for the question, and thank you, judges, for being here today. As Indians, our ancestors have heavily respected the mental health and the well-being of the physical body. Through yoga and meditation, I have respected that the Indian culture has helped me connect with myself and my body. If we are connected with ourselves and our health, health is wealth. Thank you for the question.
Indeed, thank you. Contestant, and you'll tell me your name and your number.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Rigel. I'm contestant number 13.
Indeed. Okay. If you are dating someone your parents do not approve of, what would you do? If you are dating someone your parents do not approve of, what would you do?
Thank you, judges, for the question. If I was dating somebody that my parents did not approve of, I would first think of why they don't approve of him. Then I would dig deep and find confidence in the fact that I chose that man for a reason, and that he is my life partner that I will be spending the rest of my life with. And eventually, I would make sure that my parents fell in love with him just the way I did. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I like that. Now you guys are getting the picture. Unfortunately, I have only one question for you, so I don't have to give you a choice, but I need you to say your name and your number.
Good evening, everyone. This is Shweta, contestant number 16.
Okay, Shweta. What qualities do you think that you like to see in your dream man? What qualities do you think that you would like to see in your dream man?
Thank you very much for the wonderful question. I would like to see who is respectable and kindness, who shows love, respect, kindness on everyone, and who doesn't degrade anyone, and who always encourages person, and the person should be, no need to be tall, handsome like that. I just need a right person. And he should be, have goals, dreams, and he should work on that, and he should appreciate each and every person, and he should live in the moment. I look for that kind of person. Thank you.
Speaking about living in the moment, here they are, five contestants, Miss India USA contestants. A round of applause, folks, a round of applause. Yes, and ladies, you did wonderful. I love the living in the moment part. I love everything else. It is thank you to Shweta, Ishita, Grishma, Avani, and Riju. Thank you so much.
Thank you. You did a wonderful job. Thanks for giving us a break there. Thank you, ladies. Miss India Worldwide, Khushi Patel, was unable to attend internationals in India this past year. So let's welcome Khushi for her farewell walk, and let's welcome Neelam Saran to present her with a token of appreciation. Let's hear it for our Miss India Worldwide, Khushi Patel.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Khushi Patel, and I am now your former Miss India Worldwide 2022. Today, I'm addressing a forever valued role that I played as your pageant queen and an inspiration to thousands of young ladies and children worldwide. At a young elementary school age, I started discovering my passion for the film and in the film and fashion industry. I would do ramp walks and do my own auditions in front of a blank TV and use my mother's dressing room as my own. I stand today feeling a bittersweet mix of emotions, accomplishment, gratitude, but also a thing of sadness and a highly end of a memorable chapter in my life. It has been a true journey, and now it is a lifestyle that I will follow for the rest of my life. Throughout this pageant, I've had the privilege of meeting extraordinary individuals from diverse backgrounds, cultures, and stages of life. This experience has opened my eyes to the beauty and to the richness that exists within our world. And it has taught me the importance of embracing diversity, adapting inclusivity, and working together towards a brighter and better future for us all. As I step away from the stage where I won my title, I carry with me a valuable lesson that will be projected to students and women for the remainder of my life. This pageant not only provided me with a platform to showcase my talents, but also coated me with a sense of responsibility. I thank for this Mr. Dharatma Saran and Mrs. Neelam Saran for giving me this platform and to advocate not just me, but on behalf of all the women and for their causes that are meaningful to this world's heart. I'd like to give a huge thanks to Padma Shri Dr. H.R. Shah for covering all of my shining moments with his team. Secondly, to Dr. Albert Jasani of the Royal Albert's Palace, can't forget that, and our amazing choreographers, Mrs. Nishi and Shilpa, wherever they are, you guys are awesome. And you've helped me in amazing ways in my last years here. To the next generation of the pageant contestants, I inspire you to embrace this incredible opportunity with an open heart and unwavering spirit. Remember always that the true beauty lies in authenticity, kindness, and the desire to make a difference. Embody these qualities you have been blessed with and stay true to yourself. And let your inner light shine brightly. Stay contained in your accomplishments and let the sky be the limits to your dreams. Thank you.
We would now like to invite Neelam Saran to please come up on stage to give our reigning queen a token of appreciation. Guys, please give it up for the legendary Neelam Saran. We're also presenting Khushi Patel a check of $8,000 for her successful reign. This is brought to them by IFC. Of all categories up on stage. The moment that we've all been waiting for is finally here. Please welcome the top five of every single category. Teen, Miss, Mrs. India, USA 2023. Let's hear it for our top five contestants in every single category.
Have Abhimanyu Dasani and Tanvi Grover to sash and crown our winners. Second runner-up in the teen category, Ojaswi. Jesse, we're waiting to sash you. Thank you, Jesse. Congratulations. Our first runner-up in the teen category, Vera. Congratulations, Vera, first runner up.
And now, our winner of Teen Miss India USA is Saloni. Congratulations. And now, our top three for our Mrs. category. I'd like to invite Miss Monica Gill to present the sashes and crowns for our Mrs. category. And I'll also like to invite Miss Neelam Aunty, please. Our second runner-up, Shagun. Congratulations, second runner-up, Shagun. First runner-up in the Mrs. category, Shilpi.
Thank you.
winner for the Mrs. category are Mrs. India USA is Sneha. USA to the stage, please, to crown our top three. And may I have Albert Jassani to sash our top three. Our second runner-up in the Miss category, Ishita. Congratulations, Ishita, our second runner-up. Congratulations, Ishita, our second runner-up. And now for our first runner-up. Thank you, Ishita. Our first runner-up in the Miss category. Our first runner-up is Grishma. Congratulations, Grishma, our first runner-up in the Miss category. Let's hear it one more time for our first runner-up, Grishma. Congratulations, Grishma.
Our Miss India USA is judges on stage, Dharmatma and Neelam Saran as well. Congratulations, Rijul, Miss India USA.
And congratulations to all of our winners tonight.
Thank you, ladies. Now, all of our crowned runners-up, please, you can step forward for pictures. And to the rest of you, thank you for joining us. You guys are all lovely, and congratulations.
doctor. My child is not breathing. Please save her, please.
Up next, we have Napika, contestant number 6. From Sri Devi's legendary expressions to Aishwarya Rai's dynamic energy, tonight Napika will be showcasing her love for dance with a Bollywood fusion dance routine. Is Grishma, contestant number 7. Through her talent, Grishma will bring importance to the appreciation and conservation of nature. She will sing Gagan Ave Bagi, a song in her mother tongue, Kannada.
Good evening. As Indians, we are all familiar with the immense beauty of our motherland. From
the expansive Goa beaches to the mountains of Himachal Pradesh, the lush Kerala forests to the ever-flowing Godavari River. The natural realm is essential to our being. Unfortunately, pollution and deforestation are putting nature at risk, and it is our duty to protect it. Today, I will sing to call attention to the preservation of our beautiful Mother Nature.
Ishita, contestant number 8. Ishita's fusion classical dance performance symbolizes the empowering journey of a princess triumphing over societal norms and reflecting women's strength.
Kingdom rejoices, celebrating the birth of the princess. Everyone follows her journey, witnessing her growth. She blossoms into a captivating young woman. And through relentless training, transforms into a fierce warrior princess. But then, societal norms, people's opinions, and constraints set on women shatter her. Amidst despair, goddess Durga appears. Her voice unveils the hidden strength and princess's true potential. Get up! Others' opinions don't define you. You are much more than that. Rise above and embrace your strengths.
Job, Ishita. Up next, we have Natasha, contestant number 9. Get ready for a lovely visual treat presenting a graceful semi-classical musical performance where a beautiful damsel will sing and express herself through her sangeet. Please welcome Natasha Bhave.
also welcome Jayesh Mehta up on stage real quick. Neha is going to begin with a graceful semi-classical Bollywood mix of the popular song Manike and finish with a flare of energy with the classic song Ghagra. Join us as she takes on a journey of fun, flair, and Bollywood magic. Guys, give it up for our contestants. Louder, louder.
हाय ये मेरी आंखें रात भर करे बातें तेरी ये तेरी आए जो तेरी यादें रुक रुक चले सांसें मेरी ये मेरी हाँ मुझे प्यार है तुमसे हाँ तुझ में ही तो मेरा जहां मन हारी तनहारी सुकुमारी फिर तमा हितलांग में देवते ना दूर पे मैं कपट लेना तू अनारी मन हारी सुकुमाली नंबतमा
Woohoo! Up next, we have Neha S., contestant number 11. Neha will be enlightening us with a dynamic performance, which is a Bollywood and Kathak mix. All the best, Neha. Amazing job, girl. Okay, up next we have Purnima, contestant number 12. Purnima will be presenting a captivating scene from the well-known Barbie movie that beautifully illustrates the empowerment of women. Her performance embodies strength, resilience, and the limitless capabilities of every woman.
Sorry. It is literally impossible to be a woman. Like, you're so beautiful and so smart. It kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we have to always be extraordinary. And somehow, we're always doing it wrong. You have to be thin, but not too thin. And you can never say you want to be thin. You have to say you want to be healthy, but you have to be thin. You have to have money, but you can't ask for money because that's gross. You're supposed to love being a mother, but don't talk about your kids all the damn time. You have to be a boss, but you can't be mean. You have to be a career woman. Also, always keep looking out for other people. You have to answer for men's bad behavior, which is insane. But if you point that out, you're accused of complaining. You have to stay pretty for men, but not too pretty that you tempt them too much or you threaten other women, because you have to be a part of sisterhood. Also, always stand out and always be grateful. But never forget that the system is rigged, so find a way to acknowledge that, but also always be grateful. You have to never get old, never be rude, never show off, never fail, never fall down. It's too hard, it's too contradictory, and nobody gives you a medal or says thank you. Turns out, not only that you are doing everything wrong, but everything is your fault. I'm just tired of seeing myself and every single other woman tie herself into knots just so that people will like us. And if all of that is also true for a doll just representing women, I don't even know. Thank you.
Great job. Up next, we have Rijul, contestant number 13. Rijul will be performing a semi-classical dance about following your heart and letting your dreams lead the way. Rijul. Up next, we have Shruti, contestant number 14. Shruti will be doing a Kathak performance to Ghar More Pardesiya. Job. Okay, up next we have Siri, contestant number 15. Siri's been dancing all her life and she's going to be doing Garba. This sequence is a celebration of woman power and tribute to the woman in Indian folk.
A woman, divine, powerful, and light of life. I am, therefore we are.
Next, we have Shweta, contestant number 16. Don't let a 9-to-5 define the passions that make you shine. If you have a talent deep within, it's time to let that journey begin.
Shweta, you have a meeting right now.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm busy right now.
As a dancer, my heart is at home. Dance brings me to life, makes me feel complete. My passion for it will never deplete.
Couple Grammys on him, couple plaques, ayy. That's a fact, ayy. Throw it back, ayy. Throw it back, ayy.
Thank you.
up for the contestants from the Miss section. Come on. We can do better. We're now moving to our teen talent. We have Alicia, contestant number one. Alicia, hold on for a second. Let's wait till she clears. Someone will come.